two, three, four.
I knew that I was different, and I didn't know why.
When it came to blues, there was nobody like him.
Before Eric, guitar playing in England had been very simple. Suddenly we heard something that was completely different.
It was completely revolutionary.
The minute I woke up, I just played and played.
We were recording with Ray Charles, Aretha Franklin.
People started to idolize what he was doing.
White America had never paid attention to blues. Thanks to Eric, a lot of doors was open.
I thought it was the beginning. I didn't know it was the end.
There was always a lot of cocaine, LSD, mescaline.
I was full of hatred and anger.
It got to be a point of wondering, what's going to happen tomorrow night?
It looked like he wanted to kill himself.
I was in absolute denial about my alcoholism.
Music saved me.
I thought I had this dream, the perfect band, you know, the virtuoso.
There was a way to turn this dreadful tragedy into something positive. There was always one man who was completely alone and with his guitar versus the world.
Ciao, eccovi qualche piccola curiosità cinematografica. Sapevate che Clint Eastwood, nonostante l'abbiamo visto fumare in tantissimi film, in realtà non ha mai fumato nella vita reale? Poi Steven Spielberg ha lasciato l'università e si è laureato 33 anni dopo usando come tesi Schindler's List, film che tra l'altro ha realizzato ben 10 anni dopo aver ricevuto la storia perché non si sentiva abbastanza maturo per affrontarla. È giusto, si prende i suoi tempi, Steven. Per oggi è tutto, ricordatevi di iscrivervi al canale e di attivare le notifiche. Ci potete seguire anche su Facebook e Instagram, trovate i link qui sotto e noi ci vediamo prestissimo.